one of the first operating heritage railways and was opened since 1956. It ran all the way from Borstead Keys to Barrow in Furness. Its first engine was a Black E2 called Trent. He worked hard during the line's earliest days, but the workload did prove to be too much for him, as he was built in 1901. So Oswald was run to help with the goods work, while Trent would handle the passengers. The both of them made quite the reliable team. They would become four engines when two former engines from the NWR came in 1958, 9462, 182, and 546. They were not as bad and spiteful to the other engines, but now were change engines and handled the goods and passenger work single-handedly. Three more engines in 19... Buckshire, Driscoll, and Priam. And together, they would reign happily for so many years to come under the control and guidance of Roger Sam I. But all that changed, I'm sorry to say, after the arrival of their eighth engine in 1961.
Have you heard BR's withdrawing steam now?
Aye. Those 8 whales have been replaced by 9 Fs.
Yes. I wish BR would see steam engines and diesel engines equal.
Yeah, right there, Bucky.
We are not telling Trent about this. He'll be heartbroken. You hear?
I hear.
Good day, Sir Roger.
Yes, hello to you too. I heard you're looking for an engine.
Yes, I am. Specifically, a mixed traffic engine.
Oh, you come to the right person.
I have some of the finest designs of all of Britain. An 02. A Black 5. An LMYR Class 28. A K2. And J11. Oh, there's also... Wait, did you say you had a K2?
I did, but it can only go 80 miles
an hour. I do have an
A1
that could go 100 miles an hour.
Thanks for the offer, but I'll stick with the K2.
Does it have a name?
No, just a number.
I'll sell him 30 pounds.
What was that? He soon found out.
Are you the new engine?
Yes.
I want you to go to Wiki and find to bank a train.
Alright, Ernest.
You heard him.
You have work to do.
This is Wiki Station.
Thanks, Trent. Where do I rest in the meantime?
Oh, over there.
I'll have to go call up my first passenger train.
Bye, Trent.
Ernest was waiting at Leaky Station while Trent was pulling his passenger train. Suddenly, he heard a... I think that's 87546. Are you all right, mate?
No, these trucks are holding me back.
We'll show them! With Ernest coupled to the back, the two engines set off. Things were going well, until they got halfway up, which was when things started to fall apart.
10121, there's a truck breaking.
No, this train has to get up. It has to.
But
what was that?
The truck from Ernest crashed to pieces. Soon, Trenton 9462 came up to clear the mess.
What happened here?
Sorry, sir. I was just banking the train and this happened.
You wanted to get this train over the top? And you did it single-handedly?
Yes, sir.
Really, sir? Thank you! That would be an honor, sir! Hooray for Trent! Three cheers for Ernest! Hip hip hooray! Hip hip hooray!
Ernest never felt so delighted in his entire lifetime. And for the next several weeks, he began proving himself to Roger Sam as a really useful engine. But all that changed in 1963.
Oh, bother. What is it, Briam? My firebox isn't faulty. I can't ship the coal train for 87546.
My cylinders aren't sure too, so I can't ship it either.
I guess I'll be sending it then.
Well, who's gonna take my train?
Well, 87546. To answer your question, I've already sent Ernest to take it.
Come along, Oswald.
Now that we're here, we might as well get started.
I agree.
There's a long strip of track leading to Paddington Copeland on the GWR. However, the day Ernest was taking it was a day with lightning. It caused track to bend 3/4 of the way to Paddington. This would put the railway in serious trouble.
Is this the train to Paddington, Copeland?
Yes.
You wouldn't want to end up like Carson, would you?
Carson?
Who's Carson?
Carson was one of our engines. He helped construct the line. He was a good engine in terms of getting the work done. He was bossy and annoying to me. I would always tell him that if he kept it up, he would die again. But he took no notice. Every time I warned him, he would just laugh. It did hit him hard when he fell down a mountain cliff on a day like this, hearing the same train. Be careful, Ernest. It's going to be bad weather all night.
I will.
Well, I warned him.
Thank you.
Earth had never felt so pleasing in his entire life. But that wouldn't last long.
This is red signal, boy. Up on the brakes. Now, go on!
Uh-oh. Holy sh...
Someone help!
Damn, you stupid trucks!
What is it, old boy? Oh my gosh! Oh no. Well, this is it then. What was that?
We need Joe to go over there and see if he's in trouble. As soon as Oswald to get his tender.
Yes, sir. God.
The trucks were mangled.
Coal and engine parts spilled everywhere. The tender was dented. Ernest covered in leaves, bushes, twigs. It was a terrible, terrible sight. Worst of all, Ernest had blood.
Are you alright?
No, I'm not alright.
The mess took a long time to clean up, and there was a lot. It took 2 hours, but finally, we were able to put Ernest and his tender back onto the rails.
Look at you. The manager won't like this.
I know, Trent. Trent arrived at Horsted Keys. He went up to a siding that hadn't been used in a long time, and he shunted Ernest there.
Well done, Trent. You may go and rest.
What about Ernest?
Oh, I've decided something to do with him.
Now, what to do with you?
Will I be fixed, sir?
No. The load you're pulling cost us a fortune.
You're planning to save up money for that. Now that the railway is broke, now we have to close down.
What?
I'm sorry, but this is how it has to be. And we can't prepare you because if we did, you wouldn't have enough money and you're in a terrible shape. We have nobody to mend you. Good day to you, 10121. I guess this is what I deserve. After all,
after that, things really fell apart. The railway was getting less passenger and goods traffic. Trucks decreased from 6 to 2, and passenger coaches went from large express coaches to just only about smaller ones. Many of the engines had to be sold, and unfortunately, they didn't make it. Buckshire suffered the worst out of them all. In June of 1967, the railway finally closed down, but Trent, 9462, and 87546 weren't sold anywhere.
I have gathered you all here so that we could discuss something. I've recently got a hold of the owner who owned the workshop Ernest came from, and he has agreed to send you all there. And Ernest will be kept in the sign for a long time. Trent, where do you think you're going?
To talk to Ernest.
Well, Ernest, the railway's officially closed.
Do you have anything else to say to us before you go?
Yes, Trent, I do.
I'm sorry. I was the meanest K2 on the Furness Railway. One K2 I bullied the most was an engine called Edward. He was a kind soul to me, but I wasn't a kind soul to him. I was the pride of the line, even though I was just a replacement engine. Still, I thought I was the most modern engine anyone could ever have. As punishment, the manager sent me to the workshop. And when I came here, I thought I would have a chance of redemption. Seems as if karma had other ideas. Can you do me a favor and tell Edward that I'm sorry, even if he doesn't forgive me?
Yes, Ernest, I will.
Engines also deserve forgiveness, don't they, 2546?
They do.
Don't worry, Ernest. I also forgive you.
We all do.
Thank you, Ernest. It means a lot to me. Bye.
Bye.
As the years passed, Trent 9462 and 871546 started to lose hope of being bought. Unless they were bought. By whom? The NWR. They got new looks at Cohen's Gate. Trent was repainted from British Railways black to NWR black and given a number. He worked on the Farquhar branch line as a goods engine, while pulling passenger trains from time to time, as well as banking on the main line. 9462 got new names called Alfred and Christopher. As for Ernest, however, he stayed on that siding for a long time. I mean, don't know whatever happened to him, but that's a story for another day.